evening. I'm Carolyn Donaldson, former WTHA television news anchor and current community education manager for WPSU, but most importantly, longtime friend of Special Olympics Pennsylvania. It is my absolute pleasure to yet again host this year's Athlete Leadership University Graduation and Leadership Awards. While we're unable to be together this year, we're pleased to still have the opportunity to recognize so many deserving athletes and volunteers through virtual channels that enable us to share their success with even more members of the statewide community. So let's get things started. Before we recognize and celebrate the achievements of many members of the Special Olympics Pennsylvania family who work hard to create an inclusive and welcoming world for us all, let's hear from President and CEO Matt Aaron, who will say a few words and get tonight's presentation underway.
Good evening, everyone, and congratulations to all of our nominees and awardees. Coming up soon, you're going to hear more about each of our Leadership Award recipients. We're going to present a total of 12 awards this evening in different categories, including the annual Torch Award. But first, we're going to get to see and hear from 8 of our Athlete Leadership University graduates. A huge thank you to Aramark for sponsoring our Athlete Leadership program. Aramark's commitment to diversity and inclusion includes a workforce goal to hire, retain, and develop people with different abilities, and their Thrive Employee Resource Group, or ERG, is dedicated to team members with disabilities and for caretakers and advocates for those with disabilities. We're so grateful to have a wonderful partner like Aramark. And now I'd like to introduce Jordan Schubert, our manager for Athlete Leadership and Young Athletes Programs, who's going to take us through the recognition ceremony for the Athlete Leadership University Class of 2020. Take it away, Jordan.
Thank you, Matt, and good evening, everybody. Pursuing a degree through Athlete Leadership University is the same as pursuing a degree at any other university. First, an athlete declares a major and enrolls in an introductory course. After taking the introductory training, the athlete then completes their introductory practicum. Once a practicum is complete, they can then enroll in an advanced Athlete Leadership University course. After the advanced course, in order to graduate, athletes must complete a graduate practicum. Then, and only then, can they be eligible to receive their degree in a graduation ceremony. Tonight, we have 8 individuals receiving degrees in communication, governance, and/or sport. Please allow me to introduce the Athlete Leadership University graduating class of 2020. Our first graduate is one of 6 in this class, earning what is now their 2nd degree. This individual is a Northeastern representative on Special Olympics Pennsylvania's Regional Input Council and always speaks with great joy. She is very passionate about helping her fellow athletes and is always ready to listen to other athlete representatives from throughout her region. Our first graduate is Ashley Bressler, Columbia Montour athlete representative.
Hi, my name is Ashley Bressler from Columbia Montour Special Olympics. I am so happy to have earned my 2nd degree for athlete rep 2. I love taking part in Special Olympics and teaching everyone about the sports we do and the opportunities we are given. I really enjoy being a part of the Regional Input Council and spending time with my mentor, Natalie. The graduating helps me to show other athletes how fun and cool it is to move up in athlete leadership. Thank you, Special Olympics, for all of the amazing opportunities.
Our second graduate is someone who is always ready to promote the mission of Special Olympics to several outside groups. Throughout the time she has been an athlete leader, and even before then, she has always shown the willingness to go above and beyond to help her program raise funds and awareness throughout the community. Our next graduate is Winnie Downey, Delaware athlete representative.
Family, friend, my biggest accomplishment is last December 13, 2019, I went down to the Philadelphia Eagles to meet a special people. I got to hold the championship ring, the Super Bowl ring, and I got to hold the Super Bowl trophy. The trophy was very heavy, and the ring was very beautiful. I got to see things, and I got to meet a player, and that was my highest. And I got to go to an Eagles game with my best friend and good friend, Damian Smith. And we wanted to see the Eagles play the Cowboys, and the Eagles won. We had the best time. And I thank Freedom Ride and Special Olympics for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, Winnie Downey.
Our third graduate decided he wanted to do more than just participate in Special Olympics. So he decided to become a certified bowling coach. As a bowling coach, he's been able to teach his fellow athletes how they can be the most successful they can be. Even after becoming certified, he decided to take it a step further and complete the Athletes as Coaches course in hopes of furthering his knowledge of coaching his fellow athletes. Now, he wants to continue even further as an athlete leader. So our next graduate is Anthony Gloss, Lehigh Athletes as Coaches.
Thank you, Sports Olympics, for giving me the opportunity to show what I can really do. I have been going to my sports for about 25 years. My favorite sports are basketball, soccer, and bowling. I started as an athlete, but also wanted to help out my fellow athletes. A few years ago, our bowling and bocce program did not have male volunteers for traveling. We had plenty of good coaches, but they were unavailable for overnight or full stays. I asked if I could help so my friends can go to competitions. I did the courses to become a coach for bocce and bowling. Now I can fill in where my friends need me to help. I coach at bocce and bowling and help running and setting up the bowling program with my mom. Last year, our soccer coach Amelia was talking to her son, my friend Brendan, to go up the sheets and asked if I wanted to go along. I said sure, to go up to the training facility for the university. When we arrived, we met in a conference room and then he told us what to do and to expect for the training for the entire weekend. We then went to the hotel the next day, Saturday. Then we took different classes, how to handle athlete situations that might come up. We learned a lot about healthy athletes, habits, and worked with a teaching coach, helping other athletes with sports and traveling. I had a great time with them and learned a lot of new stuff. I'm happy she asked me to go along and give me the chance to see much more of what I can do as an athlete and coaches. If you get a chance and go, you should do it. Yep, it's a good place to learn more stuff that can help you more training for you and your Special Olympic programs. Again, thank you Special Olympics and my mentor Amelia for all the help and you are and my friends. Special Olympics has always been the best for me and I will not be where I am today without them.
Our fourth graduate was inducted into the Special Olympics Pennsylvania Hall of Fame 3 years ago. In addition to his achievements as an athlete, he also made it a goal to represent his peers so that not only his local program can hear his voice, but others as well. That experience motivated him to also become a certified flag football coach. And just like our previous graduate, he also decided to take it a step further by completing the Athletes as Coaches course to gain an even greater understanding of how to support his peers in any capacity. Our next graduate is Andrew Mayer, Washington Green, athlete representative and athletes as coaches.
Hi, I'm Andrew Mayer from Washington Green County. I've been on several games organized committees. I attended every Congress and leadership conference with the help of our facilitator, Kimber Netter, and our co-chair, athlete representative, Zach Williams. For our county has started our athlete representative team, and we have a county athletes only Facebook page. For my athletes as coaches certification, my coach Andy Knight assists me with flag football and basketball general orientation. My mom and mentor helped me with protective behaviors and concussion training. I want to thank Jordan, Chelsea, Mike Armour, Jennifer Trouse. Andy Knight, Kimber Netter, and my mom for all their help and support. Thank you all.
Our fifth graduate will be earning her third Athlete Leadership University degree. One of our biggest passions is always finding ways to stay fit. When Special Olympics Pennsylvania announced that this year's summer games will be virtual, she began posting videos on Facebook, demonstrating to her peers here's the different challenges for swimming and motivating them to do the same thing. She was also just elected as one of the newest representatives on the Regional IMPA Council during last month's Athlete Congress. Our next graduate is Elizabeth Porter, Bradford Sullivan Athlete Representative.
Hello, my name is Elizabeth Porter. I enjoyed working with new and old friends at my training to become an athlete representative. I'm most proud that with the support of my mentor, Cynthia Porter, and my manager, Becky Wu, and my athlete leader friends, I was able to start the athlete leadership team in Bradford Sullivan Counties. Woohoo! I'm so excited to graduate. I want to thank Jordan and Chelsea for organizing Athlete Leadership University. Thank you.
Our sixth graduate is the second of three members of this class earning their third degree. While she was quiet when she first became an athlete leader, this individual has always been a great listener and writer. Shortly after being trained as a global messenger, she came out of her shell, which has greatly helped her advance in various roles. She is an athlete representative, floor hockey skills coach, and for the last 2 years has also served as the vice chair of the Regional Input Council. Our next graduate is Christine Progen, Lebanon Global Messenger.
Hello, my name is Christine Progen. I've been a Special Olympian for over 30 years. I have also served on the Regional Input Council as vice chair for the past 2 years, and I'm an athlete leadership graduate, athlete as coaches graduate, and as of today, I will become a global messenger graduate. Becoming a global messenger has been a dream of mine for as long as I have been competing, and now I have achieved that as well. I would like to take a moment to thank my family, friends, and mentor, Diane Wilson, for always supporting and encouraging me during my training. I have made many friends, learned many things about Pennsylvania Special Olympics, and have made many memories during my years in athlete university. I look forward to sharing with others about Special Olympics and what it means to me and my peers. Thank you.
Our seventh graduate is the third member of the class earning their third degree. Even during the most difficult times, he always has a smile on his face. Whether it's running in an event at Summer Games or Fall Fest, participating in a local or national marathon, coaching his peers in floor hockey, or reporting out to the Special Olympics Pennsylvania Board of Directors He's always someone that has every athlete, staff member, board member, and volunteer smiling. Our next graduate is Ernest Roundtree, Monroe, Athletes as Coaches.
Hi, my name is Ernie Roundtree. I'm an athlete from Monroe County Special Olympics. First, I would like to thank my manager, my county manager, Therese Crowley, and my wonderful mentor, Denise Corielli, for all they've done for me to get the opportunity to take the athlete as coach training. My favorite part of that experience was when Jennifer Tresp was my instructor and we did a 2-minute drill. And one of the fun part was I was paired up with one of the other mentors to do that. And thank my family, my extended family, for being there for me whenever I was down. Thank you, Special Olympics Pennsylvania.
Our eighth and final graduate attended Leadership Conference in 2015 to learn more about athlete leadership, and 2 years later, earned her first degree as an athlete representative. Shortly after that, she became a global messenger, which has given her even more confidence to lead various initiatives within her program. That willingness to take action was part of the reason why she was also recently elected onto the Regional Input Council during last month's Athlete Congress. Our final graduate is Kelly Eunice, Delaware, Global Messenger.
Hello, my name is Kelly Eunice from Delaware County. Attending trainings for Global Messenger has taught me how to speak at events and help spread the word about the importance of Special Olympics. It has also given me the opportunity to be co-MC at closing ceremonies at Villanova Fall Fest. What an awesome time! Graduating as Global Messenger has also allowed me to attend the most recent Athlete Congress. Something I was very proud of to be part of. I am so thankful for everything Special Olympics has done for me, from playing sports, meeting new friends, and helping me grow as a person.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the Athlete Leadership University Class of 2020. These athlete leaders wouldn't be where they are or without the support of their mentors. All athlete leaders have mentors to ensure that they are always put in a position to succeed. In addition, these athlete leaders receive great support from their local program management teams to help them provide meaningful leadership opportunities beyond competition. Lastly, Athlete Leadership University and athlete leadership in general would not be possible without the support and dedication of the entire SOPA staff and board of directors. Congratulations and thank you.
Good evening, I'm Mark Bruno. I'm the Chief Operating Officer of Aramark, and our company is a big supporter of Special Olympics. I'm also the proud parent of a Special Olympics athlete here in Pennsylvania. I wanted to spend a minute to just send my sincere congratulations to all 8 graduates of the Athlete Leadership University Class of 2020. What a remarkable achievement. We are all very proud of your accomplishments. Congratulations.
Thanks, Jordan. Congratulations, athletes, on the successful completion of your studies, and we so appreciate receiving Aramark's support. Special Olympics supports athlete leaders both on and off the field, empowering them to become respected as contributing members of society. Through organized training and practical experience, athletes develop leadership skills and utilize their voices and abilities to assume meaningful leadership roles, influence change within the Special Olympics movement, and create inclusive communities around the world. Thanks once again to Aramark for empowering the next generation of leaders. Now, the next highlight of this amazing evening is the presentation of awards honoring local program athletes and volunteers. You'll hear a few words from the individuals who nominated each of our Leadership Award recipients, followed by remarks from the actual award winners.
Terry Stickles, Local Program Manager for Adams County. On behalf of our entire program, I'd like to congratulate Carol Ann on her selection as Female Athlete of the Year. We nominated Carol Ann because she exemplifies what it means to be a Special Olympics athlete. Having trained in 5 or 6 sports in the past, last year, Carol Ann decided to challenge herself to join the swim team. Hesitant in the pool the first few weeks of practice, she trusted her coaches, followed their advice, was open to their instruction, even trained on her own time. And she progressed from being a beginning swimmer to medaling in 3 events, one of which was a gold at Summer Games. She also became a global messenger last year. She is a wonderful teammate, always encouraging her athletes, looking out for the younger athletes, and makes good suggestions to the management team and coaches about how to improve our program. Carol Ann also works and is an advocate for Tourette's. Carol Ann, we are so proud of you. Congratulations.
Special Olympics PA for giving me the award for this year's 2020 Female Athlete of the Year. I am very honored and would like to thank Adams County Special Olympics Program Manager Terry Stickles for nominating me for this unexpected award. What does this award mean to me? Well, it means the world to me. Tennis, swimming, and powerlifting were all new to me last year, which I did in addition to bowling. I would like to thank coaches Mark and Bonnie for teaching me to play tennis. I am so happy I joined the sport. I would also like to thank my swimming coach, Chris, for not only teaching me to swim for the very first time in my life, but also picking me to represent Adams County swim team in last year's 2019 Summer Games. And also to Coach Sharon for introducing me to powerlifting. Special Olympics is a very important part of my life. In this year of COVID-19, I really miss seeing and spending time with my fellow athletes. So stay safe, PA, and have a good night.
Shannon Clancy of Special Olympics Allegheny County. I nominated James Alexander for Male Athlete of the Year because he's very dedicated to his teammates, his coaches, his sports. He's always positive to be around. He is very encouraging to his teammates and everybody around him. And he loves to find new experiences and new opportunities, especially with Special Olympics. So I thought he was a great candidate for this award, and I'm so proud of him. Congratulations, James.
Hello, my name is James Alexander. I'm a Special Olympic athlete from Allegheny County. I won the 2020 Male Athlete of the Year Award, and I wish to thank my county executive coordinators that nominated me, and to all my coaches for both the JCC and the Olympic Flames, and to all my teammates, I'd like to say thank you.
Athlete leader. What is an athlete leader? Well, if you ask an athlete, they're going to tell you an athlete leader is a role model. And in Area M, we have well over 1,000 athletes, and the athletes on our athlete leadership team all act as role models to the entire program. with their positive attitude, their willingness to do whatever it takes to make things run smoothly, being there for their fellow athletes, congratulating, praising, just being there. We do have one athlete on our athlete leadership team who does stand out and meet all these requirements of an athlete leader. He checks on his fellow athletes, whether it's in the sports he participates in or other sports. He's the athlete representative on our athlete leadership team. And this year he has really stepped up and is creating the agendas for our meetings and running the meetings with very little assistance from us. He's also the athlete representative on the area management team. He brings questions and concerns that are raised at our athlete leadership team meetings, brings them to management, asks the questions, listens to the answers, listens to both sides of an issue, and then brings it back to the athlete leadership team, explaining to them why decisions have been made and how it's going to affect our program. He's also a global messenger, and the great thing about this guy is he never says no. If you ask him, he's your man, he's there. He has spoken with the Pennsylvania State Police, he's been on television with Good Day PA, he's been on radiothons, just to name only a few of the many things he's done to help spread the words about Special Olympics and the mission. His winning smile, his welcoming personality all help to make people want to contribute and help Special Olympics. So it's my honor as a mentor with the Area M Athlete Leadership Team to be nominating Zach Hicks as the Special Olympics Pennsylvania Athlete Leader of the Year.
Zach Hicks here. I'm so honored to receive this award, the 2020 Athlete Leader of the Year Award. I want to say thanks to the ones that recommended me for this amazing award. I also want to thank God for this awesome blessing. Thanks.
The Ramsey family deserves the Volunteer of the Year Award due to all the devotion, dedication, and help they provide to the Area M program. Savannah started volunteering and assistant coaching with the gymnastics team when she was in fifth grade. She demonstrates skills and choreographs and adapts the artistic routines. A year later, her sister Sierra joined the artistic gymnastics team, and her mom Sherry started volunteering, and her other sister Dixie started volunteering and assistant coaching with the rhythmic athletes. Sherry became a certified coach later and has recruited many gymnasts from the gym to join our team as unified partners and volunteers. It is due to Sherry's efforts that we were the first Special Olympics unified gymnastics team in PA when the sport was introduced in 2018. The Ramsey family has been an integral part of growing our sport for Area M. The Ramseys also participate in unified bocce teams at Northern High School, and Sierra participates in alpine skiing and athletics with Area M. It is with great honor and thanks that I get to work with such an amazing family. Thank you, Ramsey family.
Hey, it's the Ramsey family, and we just want to say thank you so much for honoring us as Special Olympics Pennsylvania Family of the Year. We are so thankful for the opportunities that Sierra has to compete and that Dixie and Savannah have to be unified athletes, and that I have to coach. We love our sports and we cannot wait to get back to practicing and being with our teams. And again, thank you so much for this honor. We are very blessed to be able to work with Special Olympics of Pennsylvania and Area M. Bye.
Hi, my name is Kay Straw, and I'm from Area M, and it's my privilege to introduce to you all the 2019 Special Olympics Pennsylvania Volunteer of the Year. This guy is amazing and is known across the state by our athletes. They all love him, and his name is Tommy Hurst. He's a DJ, a coach, the go-to guy at every fundraiser, at every event we offer. He's there supplying music, PA systems, anything you might need. He is so well deserving of this award. Congratulations, Tommy.
Hey, today in the mail I received a special award, Volunteer of the Year Award. Some of this goes to my wife as well, as she puts up with me spending time coaching and DJing and all those things. It's taxing for those that are with us, so I do appreciate that. I appreciate how it all began. I've simply stepped up and stepped in place of someone. I had something come up, and I was disc jockeying at the aquatics event in Hershey. I still remember Kay, meeting her the first time. Had everybody up dancing. And her words were, "Oh great, how are we going to get this thing started?" I pulled the volume slide down, got on the microphone, and said, "All right, everybody take a seat, we're getting started." Everybody sat down, and the rest was kind of history. These words from Kay were very critical to me. She said, "By the way, no one volunteers for an event. You volunteer for a lifetime." And now I'm part of the Special Olympics family. So happy to be part of it. Thank you all so much. I love you, and God bless.
Hello, my name is Alice Moat from Bethlehem, and we nominated Fred Knaus for Management Team Member of the Year because of all the things he does for our management team and our program. Last year, Fred was co-manager, and he was also mentor to our athlete leadership team and our athlete representatives. In addition, he organizes our annual picnic and Christmas party. He schedules our transportation to competitions, coordinates with our office neighbors who are renovating the building where our office is located, and he helps to support and advise our coaches. Fred has a positive attitude, and he is a problem solver. He helps to make things run smoothly. He is definitely a huge benefit to our management team and to our athletes. Thank you, Fred, for all you do.
For those of you that don't know me, my name is Fred Knaus, and I am a member of the management team for Bethlehem City Special Olympics. I am very honored and grateful to accept such an important award as Management Team Member of the Year. First and foremost, I want to thank my family for all of their support, and I also want to recognize the Bethlehem management team for all their support throughout the year. Our team's hard work has allowed our athletes to excel in their chosen sport. As many of you know, these volunteer positions are hard to fill, and at times we all wear multiple hats. As an organization, we are all looking to succeed, to have that feeling of success. This is an overall feeling within Special Olympics Pennsylvania, not only for our athletes, but also for our volunteers. To quote Mr. Rogers, there are three ways to ultimate success. The first way is to be kind. The second way is to be kind. And the third way is to be kind. Try your best to make goodness attractive. That is one of the toughest assignments you will ever be given. Thank you again for this award.
Hi, I'm Andy Foraker.
And I'm Shelley Foraker.
We are the coaches of Chester County's 7v7 Unified Soccer Team. This year, we have nominated Christine Stout as the Unified Athlete of the Year. Christine exemplifies what a Special Olympic athlete should be and is a true team player.
Christine always gives 100% in whatever she does on and off the soccer field. She's willing to volunteer to lead drills. She welcomes new teammates and new Unified partners with open arms. Christine has truly embraced the Fit Five philosophies that Special Olympics has rolled out and encourages her teammates to do the same. She always keeps us up to date on her progress as she's working on, again, and off the soccer field. She's willing and eager to try new things, and she always has a positive attitude. Her infectious laugh will definitely get you going.
Congratulations, Christine.
We're so proud of you. Great job.
I want to tell you something, okay?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Every year we have a leadership conference for Special Olympics Pennsylvania. Do you know that? And we usually go away, but this year it's virtual. But also, every year, we nominate different people for different awards.
Okay.
Like Coach Award, Athlete Award, Management Award, all kinds of awards.
Yeah.
And you were nominated for Unified Athlete Award.
Wow.
And guess what?
What?
You got it.
Yay!
You got it, girl!
Yay! Yay!
So, I know it's virtual this year, so otherwise you would be going with us in August, this month, to receive an award. But you will probably just be getting it in the mail. But we wanted to let you know that you got it.
Yay! I'm so happy.
And the dog just knocked me over.
All right.
Say, Molly.
Molly.
Relax.
I am
fine. Relax, Molly.
Yeah, I know. She's happy too.
Yes, she is. So.
She's happy too. Okay?
Yep. All right. Thank you
so
much.
And you know who nominated you?
Who?
Coach Shelley.
Yay! Oh my God. Thank you, Coach Shelley.
Yep. Coach Shelley nominated you. So, and I proved it because you are terrific, girl.
Yes, I am.
We love you. Yeah, we love you.
Hi, my name is Janelle Pemberton. I'm from Northampton County. I nominated Amanda Seacrest to be this year's 2020 Manager of the Year. Amanda is deserving of this award because of her strong leadership, enthusiasm, and love for Special Olympics and her 1,700 plus athletes. Her hard work and dedication shows when it comes to our athletes and events. She spends countless hours to make sure that our program runs smoothly. Even during these hard times, she put together numerous online activities for our athletes so they could still stay engaged with coaches and friends. Whether she's staying warm in the sun at summer games or freezing on the slopes at winter games, our athletes know that Miss Amanda is their number one fan and she's always there cheering them on. Congratulations, Amanda, on becoming this year's Manager of the Year.
Hi, it's Amanda Seacrest from Northampton County. I want to thank Special Olympics Pennsylvania for honoring me with the Manager of the Year for year 2020. I want to thank Janelle Pemberton and Pam Youngkin for nominating me. I would like to thank all the athletes that I work with in Northampton County. There's over 1,700 of you and I miss you all dearly. I would also like to thank my management team and all the coaches. You guys work so hard and so tirelessly with the kids, and I really appreciate everything you do. I would also like to thank my parents for giving me strong morals and values and teaching me to be a great leader. And I appreciate everyone for all the support, and thank you so much for honoring me with the 2020 Manager of the Year. Thank you.
My name is Andrew Mayer from Washington Green County Special Olympics. I nominated Andy Knight for Coach of the Year because he is a great coach in person. He coaches basketball, bowling, floor hockey, flag football, and helps with soccer. He got certified in many sports before we could find a coach for that sport. He is fair but strict about his athletes taking responsibility for themselves and their teammates. He is considered his athletes as family, and Andy Knight is Special Olympics.
Hello everyone, Coach Andy from Washington Green County. I want to thank everyone for the opportunity of the achievement this year of Coach of the Year. I would like to thank Andrew Mayer for nominating me. I would like to also thank all my athletes within Washington Green County, my management team, my fellow coaches, My passion with Special Olympics goes further in coaching and mentoring. It's just a passion of mine to just spend the time with the athletes. I just want to thank you all again. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mike Ermer, the Western Competition Director for Special Olympics Pennsylvania. I've nominated Dr. Sarah Manspeaker for the Games Organizing Committee Member of the Year for 2020. Dr. Manspeaker has been a longtime medical volunteer for Winter Games. A few years ago, her role elevated from a medical volunteer to our co-medical chair for the committee. The medical team at Winter Games has always been outstanding, going above and beyond to keep our athletes, coaches, and volunteers safe throughout the event. Dr. Manspeaker has helped that effort for years. In 2020, her co-chair wasn't able to attend the games for a very good reason, as she welcomed a new baby to her family. So Dr. Manspeaker had to shoulder some more of the workload. Again, exceeding expectations, she helped our medical team grow, spreading the mission of SOPA to a group of athletic training students from Nova Southeastern University in Florida. Among many other things that she has done for our medical committee, recruiting student trainers and professional trainers to assist with the event has been amazing. Dr. Manspeaker is a humble leader. I know that she will spread the accolades to the medical team as a whole, which is certainly appropriate, but equally as appropriate is her nomination for this award. I'm happy to nominate Dr. Sarah Manspeaker.
Hey everyone, Sarah Manspeaker here, and I just wanted to say thanks to all of you at Special Olympics for honoring me with the 2020 Games Organizing Committee Member of the Year Award. I'm truly humbled to receive it. I'd like to send a special thanks to Mike Ermer for the nomination and let all of you know that it's always my reward to serve this organization as part of the Winter Games and see the great work and successes of our athletes up at Seven Springs. My contributions would not be possible without the other members of the committee and all of the medical volunteers who come out each year to support the athletes and share their healthcare knowledge. Here's hoping that all of you are finding ways to stay active and prepare for next year's games. I look forward to seeing you there. Thanks again. Have a great week.
Hi, my name is Michelle Boone. I'm the Vice President for Sports at Special Olympics Pennsylvania, and I'm honored to present the next award. As some of you may know, our Unified Champion Schools program has been an organizational priority for the past 6 years. Within this time, we have grown the program to nearly 200 high schools within 32 counties. The initiative focuses on inclusive programming with three components: unified sports, whole school engagement, and youth leadership. In each component, an emphasis is placed on co-governance and inclusive leadership with students with and without intellectual disabilities. In order to recognize the tremendous achievements of our youth across the state, we've added this Unified Champion Schools Leadership Award. The award will be given annually to a unified pair who exemplify inclusive leadership on both their unified team and in their school community. In the inaugural year, we received 28 unified pair nominations and are so proud of these individuals and so many more for leading the unified generation. The leadership of our award recipients spreads well beyond Bocce and their unified club. They lead by example and can often be found together in the halls laughing, talking, causing positive ruckus, and sending the message that when we leave the comfort of our usual friend groups, awesome things can happen. I'd like to share a quick story. This year, they decided to take the same history class. They sat next to each other and always worked together. They didn't always agree on topics or the best way to approach a subject, but their teacher was always amazed at how they handled their disagreements and found common ground. She believed that her class learned more from these two individuals than they did from her, and said she hopes they've inspired students to see similarities in others instead of differences. Inclusion isn't just about a Special Olympics athlete attending a regular education class. It's not just about special and regular education students together on the same team, but it's what builds out from all of that. And it's about making it the rule instead of the exception. I'm extremely honored to present this award to Blaine Egan and Connor Roberts from Bald Eagle Area High School. They've built the foundation at their school and live the rule in an exceptionally positive way. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Connor.
And my name's Blaine. And we would like to thank you for choosing us for this award.
Connor, what was your favorite part about being on the bocce team?
Family, friends, show how people work together.
I agree. On the court, we were just one big family. Even our community would come out and support us like a family, and it really showed how awesome the inclusion revolution is. I'm actually kind of jealous that Connor gets to, you know, compete this year, but since I graduated, I don't. How do you feel that you actually get to compete this year?
I feel pretty good.
That's good. And even off the court, like in the hallways or in the classroom, we were still friends with each other. We were still family. Connor and I even happened to have a class with about half of the bocce team, it seemed like, and we got into so many great adventures in that class. Connor, what was Miss Dougal's class like?
Hilarious, and we had a lot of fun.
Sometimes I guess you could say we even had too much fun in the class, but it all worked out, and I just think it showed how bocce made our school a better place. Thank you again for choosing us for this award.
Congratulations, that was absolutely wonderful. Congratulations to all of our deserving award winners. And thank you to those who nominated each of these individuals and programs for recognition. Before we move on to our final award category, I'd like to take the time to give honorable mention to those individuals who were nominated for this year's awards in various categories. Even though they weren't selected to receive the awards, they are all very much worthy of our recognition and appreciation. Take a look. Next this evening, we'll present the Torch, or Program of the Year Award. The Torch Award was created to honor the program that has made an extra effort in some way to benefit the statewide strategy to support the Special Olympics mission. Last year, we honored the Montgomery County program, and now we pass the torch onto this year's award-winning program. This year's Torch Award program created a powerlifting opportunity with great support and enthusiasm from their coaches, which grew from zero participation at sectional and state events to five athletes registering for fall sectionals and four qualifying for fall festival. Their coaches are knowledgeable, passionate, and easy to work with. This program also supported the Winter Games with an athlete representative and a mentor who took on a committee chair position and brought their family along to support the event. They were tireless workers and overwhelmingly positive additions to the event and to the committee. During the pandemic, this program has been a leader in virtual activities for their athletes. They have had weekly events and worked hard to reach every athlete in the area. They maintained management team meetings virtually and have an excellent volunteer and athlete quarterly newsletter. They consistently communicate with Special Olympics Pennsylvania and their field director, providing updates and reports. And the manager is always available to share program successes and best practices during field team hot topics calls and other webinars. Please join me in congratulating the 2020 Torch Award programs, Washington and Greene counties.
I'm Scott Otterbein, County Manager for Montgomery County. one of the programs here in the eastern part of the state. And I want to pass the torch along to our friends out west in Washington, Green counties. Jody Knight is the county manager. Congratulations, Jody, and your crew. We really think you did a great job, apparently. I think I have had a fun year holding on to this wonderful bag, which you will be getting, that has a torch in it. It will have your county name on it. It's beautiful. Take it out on your tournaments. Get it out to the athletes. We had fun using it. Congratulations again for your honor.
Hello, everyone. I'm Jody Knight, Program Manager from Washington Green. I just wanted to say a big thank you from all of us here in Washington Green to SOPA for us winning the 2020 Torch Award. Thanks again. Hope to see everyone soon. Bye.
Lastly, before we close out this evening, there's one final set of individuals who deserve our recognition and applause. Special Olympics Pennsylvania's Training and Progression Plan is designed to inspire and encourage coaches to continue their education in order to be the best coach that they can be, and in turn, provide the athletes with a better experience and a desire to be the best athlete that they can be. Join us in congratulating the following coaches for achieving the levels of bronze and silver after going through the education system. Congratulations, coaches. What an accomplishment. Thank you for taking the time to see and hear from all of the 2020 graduates, award winners, and next level bronze and silver coaches. Everyone recognized tonight embodies the mission and the vision of Special Olympics Pennsylvania, an organization that is currently celebrating its 50th anniversary and is preparing to step into a new era with respect to transforming its communities to ensure full inclusion for people of all abilities. Congratulations. For more information about any of tonight's honorees, please visit specialolympicspa.org. Congratulations once again, well-deserved recognition. Thank you. And good night.